There is no hype like Deadpool hype. For years, the internet has buzzed with theories about the Deadpool franchise, and some of them are truly insane. With their imaginations fired up and more semi-questionable evidence than you can shake a dismembered hand at, these Deadpool fans have worked out some ideas about the film that have to be seen to be believed. Have fun wondering what Deadpool has in store for us, and don't forget to hit that red subscribe button to be the first to see all of our awesome new content.
My name's Cable.
Could Cable and Deadpool be related? Some dedicated Deadpool enthusiasts have come up with the completely wild idea that Deadpool is actually the father of Cable's wife in the future. The wife who Cable traveled back in time to prevent Russell Collins from murdering. They justify this theory like this. First, that when Cable talks about his wife, he mentions multiple similarities to Wade Wilson himself. His sense of humor, to be exact.
Did I leave the stove on?
While that's not necessarily a sure thing, the writers seem to lean into that fact quite a bit, leading fans to wonder if there's a reason behind it. Second, in the now infamous post-credits scene, Deadpool goes back in time to save Vanessa, which theorists believe is truly significant because of how her future child with Wade will come into play in the later films. Third, could it be the real reason why Cable decides to go back and save Deadpool's life? Of course, we see in the film that he has a change of heart after Deadpool sacrifices himself for Russell. But is it possible that Cable is also making sure that his wife lives, or is born in the first place?
You might want to look away for this. Now this little piggy went to...
Deadpool is the screenwriter. Along with pop culture references and inside jokes about the cast and crew, the Deadpool movies love to break the fourth wall, and do so every chance they get. That's why this theory actually kind of makes a lot of sense. The fan-created theory states Deadpool is actually the writer of his own movies, and isn't all that far-fetched. Deadpool loves to do things his own way, and he knows his own life better than anyone else. So what better way to make sure you get to tell your version of your life story than to write it yourself? Ryan Reynolds is credited as one of the writers of the sequel, but that begs the question. Is Ryan Reynolds really a mass crusader pretending to be a Hollywood star? Or did Wade Wilson, aka Deadpool, hire Reynolds to play him in the films? If you could cast the ideal version of yourself for a movie, we're betting more than one person would jump at the chance to be represented by Ryan Reynolds. Remember Amityville Horror? Blade Trinity? Not a bad choice, Wade. Of course, we don't believe the mutant anti-hero is a real person, but hey, in the words of Justin Bieber, never say never. A New Mutants tie-in. Fans have started wondering if there will be ties between Deadpool 2 and New Mutants. They cite the character Negasonic Teenage Warhead as the link between the two, with her age being close to that of the characters in the New Mutants. She also rocks a black and yellow outfit, which looks strikingly similar to those worn by the graduates of Xavier's School for Gifted Youngsters. Because Deadpool made his first ever appearance in the New Mutants comic books, it seems likely that there could be some overlap. With no solid information as to what the scenario of the crossover would be exactly, fans are left to speculate about how the two worlds would realistically mesh together, but have guessed that because Deadpool appears at the school in Deadpool 2, a rendezvous with the newest generation of students might be his way in. And especially since the recent departure of Wolverine, the franchise is in need of a new grumpy, reluctantly heroic bad boy.
Woo! Superhero landing! Yeah, that's really hard on your knees.
Deadpool's evil clone. This theory wondered if Deadpool himself might have been the real villain of Deadpool 2. Well, not Deadpool himself, but another Deadpool. The idea was that an evil, or more evil that is, Deadpool clone may have made an appearance at some point. There's been an evil version of Deadpool in the comics that the original had to fight, who was sewn together from other dismembered Deadpool parts, and this theory pays homage to that. Fans hope that this clone would have even grown out of the severed hand from the first movie, though there were no guesses as to why or by who. We know that the creators of this franchise are intent upon avoiding having our anti-hero save the world and destroy entire cities in the process, like, say, every other superhero movie. And while this theory didn't exactly come true, we got a little taste of it in the post-credits scene, when the universally ridiculed, speechless, intensely creepy version of Deadpool from X-Men Origins Wolverine met his untimely demise at the hands of, well, himself. But the better version of himself. Satisfying fans and actors named Ryan Reynolds everywhere.
Hear the music.
He was a mutant all along. Just in case you aren't familiar with his backstory, Wade Wilson became Deadpool because he signed up for an extremely risky experimental treatment to cure his terminal cancer. As is expected from these types of origin stories, the treatment did not go as planned. While he does end up cancer-free, the experiment not only ignites his mutant self-healing gene, but it also leaves him horribly disfigured. While the mutation explains one part of his abilities, it doesn't explain his unbelievable fighting and sharpshooting skills. Skills so unbelievable they might even be considered inhuman. This theory states that Wade had always been a mutant, with multiple gene mutations. The first being his impossibly fast reflexes, which he had always known about, and the second being his newly awakened ability to heal, making him almost unkillable. Fans had speculated that this might be an important aspect of the sequel, but would not be given the satisfaction of being right this time. While not addressed in this film, it's still an interesting idea, and who knows what the writers will decide to explore next.
You read these in your spare time? Oh yeah, Charles, we got ourselves an X-Men fan.
Deadpool takes place inside the comics from Logan. This one is a bit of a brain teaser. In the film Logan, we find out that the X-Men and other mutants have been turned into fictional characters in a series of comic books, a fact which distresses Logan as their exploits have been misrepresented and glamorized from the way things actually went down.
Maybe a quarter of it happened, and not like this.
Fans have speculated the Deadpool movies are taken from these fictionalized comic book timelines. The evidence is muddy, and not the most concrete, but they say that the reimagined comic book artwork from Logan actually lines up with how some of the Deadpool characters look in the films. Colossus looks exactly the same in the movie as he is represented in these comics, and fans think it could explain how Logan and Gambit suddenly ended up in 2010, having been in the 1980s in X-Men Origins Wolverine. Wade Wilson was actually a real-life mercenary who was working with the X-Men in the 80s, but in these comics is transported to the 2010s as well. It would also answer some questions about how Negasonic Teenage Warhead is even alive, as it has been confirmed that no more mutants were born after the early 2000s.
You got me in a box here.
Deadpool is Ernest Hemingway. Now, this theory is one for the ages. Some extremely dedicated fans think they've found enough clues to come to the conclusion that Deadpool is actually the great American author, Ernest Hemingway. Stay with me here. Let's start with the infamous first teaser released for Deadpool 2. The teaser shows Deadpool attempting to pull off a Superman-style phone booth quick change and failing miserably. At the very last moment before the teaser cuts to black, a large scrolling white text flashes on the screen. Apparently, the text is actually a summary of the Hemingway classic, The Old Man and the Sea. When no one could really figure out why it was placed there, the conclusion was drawn that Deadpool is Hemingway. Some other evidence to support the theory is that another villain in the Deadpool universe has claimed to be the real Wade Wilson in the past, and Deadpool himself has relatively unclear memories about his own origins. Also in the comic series, Wolverine has an actual friendship with the author, who is possibly a superhero himself. Not to mention, Hemingway was described as gruff, sarcastic, intelligent, and shrewd, all which sound pretty similar to someone else we know. Someone who wears a whole bunch of red and likes to look directly into the camera.
Wow, nice suit! Zip it, Stanley!
Uncle Ben died in the teaser. The original teaser for Deadpool 2 was actually titled No Good Deed. One theory places another of our favorite heroes at the scene, though, like Deadpool, he is unable to make it just in time to save the day. Fans wonder if the old man who was shot before Deadpool is able to untangle himself from the phone booth is actually Uncle Ben, beloved caregiver of Peter Parker, aka Spider-Man. Because we know Uncle Ben was shot during a robbery, and because we know how much the creators of this franchise love to reference anything and everything they can get their hands on, it's not so unthinkable this crossover could be the real deal. Fans wonder if the inclusion of the so-called Uncle Ben in the teaser could hint at a future Spider-Man appearance in the franchise, seeing as they both exist in the Marvel Universe. Deadpool also references how out of place a phone booth is in today's world, making some wonder if he had gone back in time to save Uncle Ben, but as usual, things didn't quite work out. Could all of these clues be hinting at some major plot points in future Deadpool movies? We wouldn't put it past the brains behind it all.
We need backup. We're gonna form a super duper f***ing group.
Who will Julian Dennison play? We know because of the appearance of Negasonic Teenage Warhead that the creators of Deadpool have a thing for reinventing some of the more obscure and lesser-known comic book characters. But fans have been wondering about who Julian Dennison's character would be. If you don't know Julian Dennison, then we suggest that as soon as this video is over, you watch Hunt for the Wilder People, where the young actor broke out of New Zealand obscurity and into all of our hearts. Fans had been speculating based on the trailers as to who exactly Julian would be playing, and concluded that it could very well be Neil Shara, aka Thunderbird 3. They were close, but Dennison's actual character is Rusty Collins, aka Firefist. They changed him from a skinny 16-year-old from Oklahoma who ends up in the Navy to the orphan with a sailor's mouth in order to build this new iteration around the talented young actor.
Move or die.
Cable's other half? Here's what we do know about Josh Brolin's Cable. In the comics, Cable was sent to the future to be cured of a techno-organic virus, but before he underwent treatment, a clone was made of him in case things went south. That clone was then kidnapped and taken in by Apocalypse, named Strife, and raised as his protege. Because of this, Strife grew up with the ideals of mutant supremacy, and a hate for the rest of humanity. Fans had been wondering if both Cable and Strife would both be making an appearance in the new movie, as Strife and Deadpool have quite a history in the comic books. Unfortunately, that theory was almost entirely based off of an Instagram picture that Josh Brolin had posted, in which he is seen looking ferociously and screaming at himself in the mirror, as you do, and we now know that Strife is not actually in Deadpool 2. It seemed to fans that Strife is just too important to Cable's story to leave out entirely. But with Josh Brolin having signed on for a 4-movie deal with Marvel to explore Cable's story, there's going to be plenty of time for the writers and creators to dig deep into all aspects of this character.
Yeah, I'll be on the lookout for the next 4 movements.
What did you think of this list? Are you as hyped for the new Deadpool movie as we are? Was there anything that you hoped had been explored in this second installment? Now we just can't wait to find out what happens in future films and read more amazing theories about all the future sequels. Hit the red subscribe button to stay up to date with all of our newest and most exciting Screen Rant content.